Hi everyone, welcome to this video discussing the experiment on how to determine the molecular weight of carbon dioxide gas. The goal here is to measure several experimental variables that we can use to calculate the molar mass of CO2 gas, which we can then compare to the theoretical molar mass. Let's start with the ideal gas equation, PV equals nRT. We can express the number of moles here as the ratio of mass to molar mass. If we isolate the molar mass to one side, it'll be equal to mRT over PV. This means that we will need to measure four experimental variables, mass, temperature, pressure, and volume of the gas to be able to calculate its molar mass. Let's start with a brief overview of the experimental setup. You will carry out a reaction to produce your CO2 in the flask labeled A here, and you will collect the CO2 gas in the flask labeled B. Later, I will discuss what all the different parts are, but right now I just want you to understand that the gas will be collected in an Erlenmeyer flask. To measure the temperature of the CO2, we simply put a thermometer inside flask B when it's full of CO2. To get the pressure of CO2, we can measure the pressure of air in the room. This is because the CO2 in the flask is allowed to equilibrate with air in the room, so the pressure of air is equal to the pressure of CO2. The pressure of air will be measured using barometer inside the lab. Now let's talk about measuring volume of CO2 in the flask. Remember that volume is just space available for a substance to occupy. This means that we need to find the actual space available in flask B. We can do this by filling that space up completely with water and then using density and mass to calculate the volume of water in the flask. The steps go like the following. Measure the mass of just flask B when it's empty, which really means that it has air in it. Then fill that flask up with water to the top and measure the mass again. Subtract the two masses to obtain the mass of just the water. Then measure the temperature of the water. We do this because the temperature of the water determines its density. There's a table in your lab procedure showing exactly that. So find the density corresponding to the temperature you measure. Then use the mass of water divided by its density to get the volume of water. This will be the same volume you have when the flask is completely filled with CO2. Lastly, we need to discuss how to obtain the mass of CO2. This is not as easy as measuring the mass of water that we just did, so let's discuss why not. Typically, if we want to measure the mass of solid or liquid, we do the following. We measure the mass of the container alone, we then add solid to the container, and then measure the mass of the container with the solid. We then get mass of the solid by subtracting the mass of the container plus solid minus the mass of the container only. This is what we did earlier when we calculated the mass of water in our flask. Now, if you think about it, the quantity we calculate when we subtract the two masses is not exactly equal to just the mass of solid. The reason is because when we weigh just the container, it actually contains air. So when we subtract the two masses, what we get is really the mass of solid minus my air in the container. Now, we assume that this mass is equal to the mass of solid. In other words, that the mass of air in the container is zero. This assumption is reasonable because the density of solid is much higher than the density of air, which means that the mass of solid in the container will be much, much larger than the mass of air in the container. So here's an example. If our solid is iron, its density is 7.86 grams per cubic centimeter. If we have a small sample of about 2 cubic centimeter, its mass will be 15.72 grams. In contrast, the density of air is 0.00123 grams per cubic centimeter. A beaker full of air at about 400 milliliter would only weigh about 0.492 grams. This means that the mass of air is only about 3% the mass of the iron sample. Now let's consider filling that same beaker up full of water, which has a density of about 1 grams per mil. For that same size beaker, we see that the mass of water is now 400 grams, which makes the mass of air about 0.1% of the mass of water. So in both cases, we see that the mass of air is small relative to the mass of either solid or liquid in the same container. This is the reason why we are able to disregard the mass of air in our calculation. In today's experiments, though, we can't do that. The reason is because the substance we're weighing is CO2, a gas with similar density to air. If we make the same assumption with CO2 as we did with a solid or a liquid, our error rate would be 60%. So how can we get the mass of CO2 in the collection flask? We must subtract the mass of the flask with CO2 in it from the mass mass of the empty flask, which is the mass of the flask without any air in it. Now, one way to get the mass of the empty flask is if we remove the air using a vacuum pump, for example. But in this experiment, we will instead try to determine the mass of the air inside the flask, and then we would subtract that mass out from the mass of the container with air at the beginning. So how do we determine the mass of air? Just like we did earlier with water, we will use density, and we would calculate the mass of air by multiplying the density times its volume. Now, to get the volume of air, remember that if the space is filled with air, then the volume of air would be the same as the volume that we get earlier for water. So if we know the density of air, we can multiply the density and volume to get the mass. The density of air can be found by measuring the pressure and temperature of air in the room. In your lab procedure, there's a table that shows this relationship, which is shown here. So once we know the mass of air in the flask, we can subtract that mass from the mass of the air and the container at the beginning and get the mass of the empty flask, which will allow us eventually to get the mass of the CO2. Okay, let's see how to do this calculation in the following example. So a student obtains all the data needed for the experiment. Notice the green highlighted values. Those are the values that you will obtain by consulting the two tables, this one and this one that I mentioned earlier. One value is for the density of water and the other value is for the density of air. Okay, so we have to use the equation shown here to get the molar mass of the CO2. We already have the pressure and the temperature, but we need the volume and the mass values for CO2. The volume, if you recall, will be the same as the volume of water in the flask, which we can calculate by dividing the mass of water by its density. The mass of water we can get by subtracting the mass of the flask with foil with water, which is right here, minus the mass of the flask and the foil with just air, which is right here. This gives us a volume of water of 272.045 milliliter, which is also the volume of our CO2. Now, for mass of CO2, first we must determine the mass of air by multiplying the air's density by its volume. One mistake that often is made here is to forget the unit of air's density, which is grams per liter, not grams per milliliter, like the density of water. So the resulting mass of air is very small, at about 0.325 grams. Now, we can calculate the mass of the empty flask, which is just the mass of the foil plus flask plus air minus the mass of air. This number is 130.2284 grams. Lastly, we can now obtain the mass of CO2 by taking the mass of the flask when it's full with CO2 and subtracting the mass of the empty flask. This gives us 0.44755 grams. Now we can put all the numbers together in our equation, keeping in mind that the significant figure in this case is limited to 3 based on the operations we have performed in the earlier steps. So in the end, that gives us a molar mass of 40.2 grams per mole. We can now calculate the percent error and accuracy by comparing our number with a theoretical molar mass of 44.0 and getting an 8.64% error. In the next video, I will discuss the experimental details of this lab.